Hello everyone, welcome back to Seek and Find Learning. So today this video is the continuation of the previous video of the current affairs of April 2021. So let's start. The first topic is Nishi Day. April 19 is celebrated as Nishi Day every year. And the Nishi Day that was celebrated in the year 2021 was the 14th Nishi Day. And the 14th Nishi Day was celebrated at the Nishi Elite Society Secretariat in Richi, Julang. It was on this day that the parliament recognized Nishi. The Nishi community is the largest ethnic group in Arunachal Pradesh in Northeast India. It is the largest ethnic group in Arunachal Pradesh. And here the word Ni, N-Y-I, refers to a human, and the word She denotes a being, which combined together refers to a human being. And the Nishi Day is celebrated to commemorate the historic constitutional amendment of replacing nomenclature Dafla to the original nomenclature Nishi. So the questions that are likely to be asked from this topic is, when is Nishi Day celebrated? The answer is April 19. And what does Nishi means? The answer is a human being. The next topic is E-Sanjeevani OPD. OPD means outpatient department. The Health Minister of Arunachal Pradesh, Alo Libang, launched telemedicine services from the TRIMS Telehub through the eSanjeevani OPD platform. So, about eSanjeevani, the eSanjeevani OPD platform was launched by the Union Ministry of Health and Family Welfare under the National Teleconsultation Service. And through this service, everyone can avail the teleconsultation services from their homes without going to the hospital at the first place. Here, doctors and specialists are available for consultation on the hub. And it will be available on all working days from 10 a.m. to 12 p.m. initially, but the timing will be increased as and when required. So everyone in need of healthcare services can avail teleconsultation services using the eSanjeevani OPD. And it is available as a mobile application as eSanjeevani OPD. You can see it here. And this mobile app can be downloaded from the Google Play Store. The questions are, who is the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare? The answer is Dr. Harshvardhan. And question number two, who is the Health Minister of Arunachal Pradesh? The answer is Alo Libang. And what is eSanjeevani OPD? It is a national teleconsultation service. First International Democracy Goodwill Ambassador, writer and senior journalist Bidayak Das from Northeast India has been made the first International Democracy Goodwill Ambassador by the Korean Development Foundation for contributing to the development of democracy and honoring the spirit of those who have committed themselves to the democratization process in the country. The award-winning journalist Bidayak Das is originally from Shillong, where he was associated with several local, regional and national English dailies, including The Telegraph until 2007. The International Democratic Goodwill Ambassador is an honorary position that will be commissioned for 2 years, that is from 1st May 2021 to 30th April 2023. So the question that can be asked here is, who has been made the first International Democratic Goodwill Ambassador by Korean Development Foundation? The answer is Bidayak Das. India ranks 87th in Global Energy Transition Index. India has been ranked 87th in Global Energy Transition Index among 115 countries. And this index is published by the World Economic Forum. And this index tracks nations on the current performance of their energy systems across various aspects. And the first is Sweden, that Sweden has been ranked in the first position, followed by Norway. So Norway is in the second position. The questions that can be asked are, what is the rank of India in Global Energy Transition Index 2021? The answer is 87th. And the next question is, where is the headquarters of World Economic Forum located? The answer is Cologne, Geneva, in Switzerland. E-property cards. The Prime Minister Narendra Modi launched the distribution of e-property cards under the Swamitva scheme. Under this, many property owners were given their e-property cards on National Panchayati Raj Day, that is on 24th April, also marking the rolling out of the Swamitva scheme for implementation across the country. About the Swamitva scheme. Swamitva stands for Survey of Villages and Mapping with Improvised Technology in Village Areas. And it was launched by Prime Minister on April 24, 2020. And it is a central sector scheme to promote a socio-economically empowered and self-reliant rural India. This scheme paves the way for using the property as a financial asset by villagers for availing loans and other financial benefits. Thus, the scheme has the potential to transform rural India using modern technical tools of mapping and surveying. The questions are, Swamitva stands for Survey of Villages and Mapping with Improvised Technology in Village Areas. And the next question is, who is the incumbent Union Minister of Panchayat and Rural Development? The answer is Narendra Singh Tomar. National Climate Vulnerability Assessment Report. According to a National Climate Vulnerability Assessment Report, 8 Indian states are found to be highly vulnerable to climate change. And the title of the report is Climate Vulnerability Assessment for Adaptation Planning in India Using a Common Framework. The report pointed out that these states, which are mostly in the eastern part of the country, requires prioritization of adaptation and interventions. And this report is released by the Department of Science and Technology. And the incumbent secretary of the Department of Science and Technology is Ashutosh Sharma. He is the incumbent secretary of the Department of Science and Technology. So this report identifies the most vulnerable states and districts in India with respect to the current climate risk and key drivers of vulnerability. So the 8 states are Jharkhand, whose capital is Ranchi, Mizoram, Aizawl, Chhattisgarh, Raipur, Assam, Dispur, Bihar, Patna, and also we have Arunachal Pradesh, Itanagar, Orissa, Bhubaneswar, and West Bengal, Kolkata. The questions that are likely to be asked are, who is the Minister of Science and Technology presently? The answer is Harshvardhan. And the next question is, according to a National Climate Vulnerability Assessment report, which states has been found to be highly vulnerable to climate change? So it can be given as MCQs. So you have to remember all these 8 states. They are Jharkhand, Mizoram, Chhattisgarh, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh, Orissa, Bihar, and West Bengal. And we have some important one-liners. Dada Saheb Phalke Award 2021 has been conferred to Rajnikant. The superstar Rajnikant has been conferred with the prestigious Dada Saheb Phalke Award 2021, and it was announced by the Union Minister of Information and Broadcasting, Prakash Javadekar. First Indian woman sailor to qualify for Olympics, and she is Netra Kumanan. She will be the 10th Indian to qualify for a sailing event in Olympics, but all the earlier 9 have been men, so she's the first woman. Longte Yullo Festival is celebrated by Nishi tribes. Tika Utsab. It is a vaccination festival for COVID vaccine. Momol Festival is celebrated by the Tangsha tribes of Arunachal Pradesh. Gumkum Gumpa Festival is celebrated by the Puroi communities of Arunachal Pradesh. And lastly, we have the important days of the month of April. April 7, it is observed as the World Health Day globally under the leadership of the World Health Organization. And it is observed to draw attention among the people towards the importance of global health. The theme of 2021 is building a fairer, healthier world for everyone. April 10, World Homeopathy Day. It is observed every year on 10 April to pay tribute to the founder and father of the homeopathy system of medicine, Dr. Christian Frederick Samuel Hahnemann. The main objective is to spread knowledge about homeopathic medicine in public health. April 13, Jallianwala Bagh Massacre. It took place on 13 April 1919 at Amritsar on the day of Baisakhi festival, and on this day British troops under the commander of General Dyer fired on a large crowd of unarmed Indians in Amritsar, Punjab of India. So several people were killed and many were wounded. April 14, Ambedkar Jayanti. B.R. Ambedkar Remembrance Day. And it is observed to commemorate the birthday of Babasaheb Bhimrao Ambedkar, an Indian politician and social rights activist. April 21, National Civil Service Day. On 21st April 1947, the then Home Minister Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel addressed the probationary officers at the All India Administrative Service Training School at Metcalfe House, Delhi, and he delivered a powerful speech and referred to the civil servants as the steel frames of India. And on this day, Prime Minister's awards for excellence in public administration are also given. And next we have World Art Day, that is observed on April 22. This day is observed every year on 22nd April to mark the anniversary of the birth of the modern environmental movement in 1970, and it is celebrated to increase awareness about the importance of the planet. April 25, World Malaria Day. And it is celebrated every year to raise awareness about the disease malaria and measures needed to control and eradicate the disease. So this is the end of the current affairs of April 2021. And in my next video, I'll be uploading the current affairs of the month of May and June. So that's all for today. And for PDFs, I've uploaded all the PDFs in my Telegram channel, so please download it from there. And I've given the link of my Telegram channel in the description below. Thanks a lot.